Hello, Internet. Welcome back to the data science community. In the last two episodes, we took the time to pre-process all of our data, and now it's ready to be mined. Our data is now 100% ready to be mined, and it's just begging for a machine learning model. However, this video is not about machine learning. It's about feature engineering. It's where we extract more data from our data. So it's, if you want to get your hands dirty and just build a model, go ahead and skip to the next video. It won't affect your ability to build models. For those of you who stay, today we'll be going over how to feature engineer in Azure ML and introduce you to the R script module. I'm not going to be teaching you R though. That's just another series for another day. I'll simply be teaching you how to use the R module within Azure ML Studio. So what is feature engineering? Well, feature engineering is when you can derive more data from your data. Since feature engineering is a huge topic, I'm only going to cover one case today. So in this case, I'm going to cover specifically how to convert numerical continuous data into binned categorical data. So for example, if you have humidity and temperature, you might be able to quantify if it's a good day or a bad day. From age, you might be able to quantify if they are a child or an adult. Maybe with age and gender, you can create a column that says is draftable or can go to war as a true false. Or maybe the number of years worked will equate to senior or junior staff level. So here's an example of a table that I've engineered. So you'll notice that we have a brand new column called age group. And actually I derived that from our pre-existing column age. So I've quantified that if they were below 8, they would be quantified as a child. If they were above 8, they would be identified as an adult. So from the newly engineered column age group, I was able to create a data visualization pie chart that asked the question, did being a child affect whether or not you lived or died? And from this graph, children survived on average 70%. All right, let's get to it. So you want to go into data transformation. Under scale and reduce, you'll find a module called the Quantize module. So just simply drag your data into it. The Quantize module will let you bin your data. With the child and adult example, I simply used the custom edges binning mode, and I used a cutoff of 8. So this is going to create a two classification output. Any person's age who is less than 8 will be binned as 1, and every single person that's over the age of 8 will be binned as 2. And I'm going to launch the column selector and specify that I want no columns, but I want to select the column name, and the column I'm trying to target to bin is age. So I'm just going to select that and hit OK, and then I'm going to run the model. Once that's done running, go in and visualize the quantized data, and you will notice that there is a brand new column added to our data set. And you will notice that every time there's a 1, it means there's a child below 8. And anytime that there's a 2, it means it's an adult above 8. And that's really all there is to it. You can rename age quantized if you want to age group or something more meaningful, but I'll let you guys do that by yourself. You guys already know how to do that. I showed you in a previous video. Now what I'm going to show you is the R module. So simply go under R languages and modules, just drag in the execute R script module. The R script module can take in 3 input parameters and 2 output returns. It can take up to 2 data sets, the second one being optional. It can take in a script bundle and it can output an R device as well as the results. Today we'll only be working with 1 data set, so go ahead and drag that into the R script module. And if you click on the R module, you'll notice that there's a whole bunch of prepackaged code already there for you. And what this code serves to do is it opens up the API a little bit for you to see what's inside of it. So this line right here is actually going to output to this node right down here. And anything you plot or anything you visualize, such as a histogram or anything like that, is actually going to go into the R device output. And then you will notice that these two up here are actually reading the parameters. So dataset 1 mam import 1 is actually going to read from the first node, and then the second node is going to read from the second dataset node. And this line right here only serves to bind the two datasets together that you did up there into the bottom output data. This module is great for copying and pasting code that you might already have on hand, or you can just start typing R code yourself into this module. Now keep in mind, commenting is a little different than what you're probably used to in R. Commenting has to be on its own specific line. The pound symbol also needs to be the first thing in the line if you're doing a comment. So for example, if I had a space to begin the comment, this would actually break the entire comment. The pound symbol actually needs to go first, and you also can't comment in line like you do here, since the pound symbol actually needs to be the first thing in the line. Now that you have a quick overview of what the R module can do, I'm going to pull up some quick R code that I've written before, and this code is actually meant to be copy and pasted into RStudio. And this R code is doing the same thing that we did earlier with the Quantize module. It is binning the numerical column of age into child and adult categorical bins, and then it's creating a pie chart at the very end. So this code is actually meant to be copy and pasted in RStudio. I'm just going to show you an example of that real quick. I have RStudio opened up, and I'm just going to copy and paste, and it's going to go into RStudio. It's going to reform and transform the data and create a pie chart. But I'm going to show you how this code can quickly be adapted to the R module. So let's go over this code really quick. So Titanic 3 is basically our fully transformed data with the child and adult group added in. And then you'll notice here that we're reading from a CSV in this code specifically. However, since we already have the data feeding in as data set 1, we'll just reroute Titanic later. So we'll copy everything except for the top line into our code. So I'm going to go ahead and copy paste everything except for the top row. And then I'm just going to paste it into the R script module. And you will notice that our Titanic dataset's reading in dataset 1, and we don't have a dataset 2, so I'm just going to go ahead and overwrite that as well. I'm going to leave the final output port though, because we're going to have to output our data. So Titanic 3 is what we want to output, so that's our results data after all the transformations taking place. So I'm going to insert that into the man output 1, and we will also notice that the Titanic dataset's referred to as Titanic in this script. So instead of dataset 1, I'm just going to rename it to Titanic. Now our R script is successfully adapted to our R module, and I'll just run the script. When that's done, just go ahead and visualize what happened in the results data. So I'm just going to visualize that, and then you will notice that age group got successfully added to the end, and you will notice that every time that someone's below 8, it's labeled as a child, and anyone else is labeled as an adult. And the R device, if we visualize that, that basically plotted our pie chart. The pie chart got outputted to the R device, and the output of Titanic 3 got sent into the results data. Also, which you will notice that we rerouted data 1 and renamed it into Titanic. That concludes the tutorial on how to feature engineer in Azure ML, where I introduced the Quantize module as well as the R script module. Join us next time where we will build our first machine learning model to predict whether or not a person would have survived the Titanic. Moving forward, I will not be using the dataset that we engineered in this video. We will instead resume the tutorial where we left off last time after we finished scrubbing all of our data of missing value.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.